Today you are going to understand and learn how to do Elliott Wave Analysis, which will help you to make better investment and trading decisions, and you will ultimately make more money for you. Hey guys, welcome to another video. This is Sharat Nik from TradingSutra, and today we are going to learn Elliott Wave Analysis. TradingSutra is an online platform where you can learn anything and everything about trading and investment. So if you haven't subscribed to this channel yet, do it right now and press the bell icon so that you get notified when we go live or, you know, upload any new video. And guys, make sure to like this video and do comment if you have any query, and we will try to help you out with that. Guys, with TradingSutra, my main aim is to help traders and investors to make money, or at least educate them enough so that they stop losing money in the market. We recently did a webinar on this topic called Elliott Wave Analysis, and on the huge demand, we are making this video live. But guys, I just want to update you that this is the edited version of that webinar, as that webinar was of approx, 3.5 hour long. But trust me, all the important stuff are available in this video. Let's talk a little about that webinar. That session was conducted by Manish Bhardwaj. He's a technical analyst and he is trading and investing in the market from last 5 years. And he uses Elliott Wave Analysis in making, you know, his financial decisions. And before this session, he wrote an article on Elliott Wave Analysis at TradingSutra.com. And guys, you can find the link in the description, and I request you just go through that article to understand the Elliott Wave Analysis, and you can use that article as a reference with this video. Guys, this session was done with the vision of teaching you guys, so you might find few law or rules which are repeated again and again, but guys, those were repeated just to make you guys revise while learning. So I request you just watch till the end, and you will get to know a lot of stuff. And in this video, we have taken crude oil and Avenue Supermart, that is DMart, as example. But in live session, there were more than 4 stocks like SDFC, AMC, Hexaware, and we also talked about USD, INR. So after this video, just try it on several other stocks. I'm sure you will gain some confidence. And guys, now you'll be listening to Manish. I'm sure you're gonna learn something amazing today. I'll be back at the end of this video. See you soon.
So, mystery of waves. Who invented this wave theory? Ralph Nelson Elliott. What he has done, he has just analyzed the years of data of the Dow Jones. And he analyzed the whole data, and up to 75 years of stock market behaviors. He analyzed this previous 75 years of stock market behavior. And after that, he came to know that the market runs in a particular pattern, which reoccurs again and again in the market. And he named these patterns as the waves. So he had just analyzed this 75 years of whole market behavior and named this as a wave. And he called this as a wave theory. The market runs in a particular patterns, waves. So we are going to analyze and we are going to know about how these waves look like, how this wave works. And there are certain principles, there are certain rules to follow this wave theory. So we will be having a great discussion over the wave theory. So let us start. What is wave theory? And so I have posted some images regarding the waves, wave theories, and this articles having 2 images. So basically what waves tells, this tells about the psychology of the crowd, what the crowd are doing. Grasping that psychology of the traders, we move with the market, we identify the trade, we identify the trend, we identify the potential of the particular stocks. So basically the wave analysis, Elliott wave theory, is for long-term investment purpose. Okay. But yes, you can apply this onto swing trading. And if you know the direction of the swing trading, if you know the short-term direction, you can also apply it to the intraday also. So if you apply in a very subdivision manner from the, let us say we started from the monthly chart, then weekly chart, then daily chart, and we jumped into the hourly chart. And you can also apply that on the 15-minute charts also. So first of all, we have to just be with the trend. Okay. And as everyone knows and everybody say also, the trend is friend. So how to identify the trend also? And what's the next move? What can be the next probable move we can identify with this Elliott wave theory? So let me introduce 2 very basic thing. Okay. What we call if something goes from up to down, we say this as like this is a bear trend. And what we say if something goes from down to top, we say is as a bull trend. So look at this. If I combine this, this is the bull and this is the bear. So this count as a one, this count as a one, and this both makes a one and two. Okay, this one and two. I am just starting from like something like very basic thing. First, small trend, like first is bull, second is bear. Now, if I continue with making these waves, I call this as a wave. I don't see candles. I don't see any something like hourly candle or weekly candle. I am just analyzing the short trend and just merging them, okay, to find out what is happening in the terms of the waves, which wave is going to form. So let's see. First, bear, and this is bull. If I combine this both, okay. Now, let us start with the two. This is bear, okay. And let's say this is bull. If I combine these both, what we will see? Okay, so this count is one, one means one and two. So this is, we call it as a wave one and we call it as a wave two. Now, if I took this wave and combined this, like this is wave, bear wave in the three wave structure, and this is the bull wave in the five wave structure. If I combine this, what happened? One, two, three, four, five. One, two, three. So here we see 1 plus 1, 2, okay? And here, 5 plus 3, 8. Similarly, if I go with combining this whole 3 and 5 structure for a better insight, we can more go into the subdivision, like look at this. If I say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, this is the 5 down. And if I say 3 up, 1, 2, 3, and again, 5 down, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. This is something like bear trend. And if I say in bull market, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, 1, 2, 3. Again, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now, against the trend, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, and 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What I have done here, look at this. I have just chosen this, okay, this part, and this bull part. I've combined this, okay. So this part, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and again, a 5 structure, 5 wave structure on the upside, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this was count as a one, and I have just put it this bear trend. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And 1, 2. This is 1, 2. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So these are the waves. You can identify this on the higher time frame, on any short-term time frame. You can look over the market. What is happening in the market? How these waves are forming? So let us see what has Elliott said. Look at this. This was the wave one, wave two, and wave three. If in a bull market, we travel in the five wave structure. One, two, three, four, five, which are with the trend. And the three wave structure, which are corrective, which we say as a correction, which are against the trend. One, two, three. So this was a small correction. Again, we have seen one, two, three, four, five. And against the trend, one, two, three. Again, we have seen the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this 5, 3, 5, 3, 5, this is the wave 1 on a higher time frame, on a larger degree. So if we say this is the wave 1, no, just wait and see what is happening in the market, where the wave 1 will complete. So what are the waves? Why we call wave 1 and wave 2? How we consider this wave 1 and wave 2? Before going deep inside this analysis, I'm just trying to teach you some glossaries regarding this Elliott wave analysis. So there are something like motive waves. So motive waves, what are the motive waves? Okay, the goal of the motive waves is to make the progress. There are certain rules which assures this the progress is going on. And there are something 4 to 5 rules and some guidelines. So before going to the rules, I just want to tell you one universal law. So what is that law? Nothing can be 100%. In this world, nothing can be 100%. You cannot say, yes, he has accuracy of 100%. No, this is the against rule. This is the against the law of the nature. Nothing can be 100%. Like I cannot be 100% successful. And nobody can be 100% successful. Nobody can predict the market 100%. So this is the law. We can break the rules, but we will have a warning for that. Okay, but we cannot break the laws. If you break the laws, you will be punished. Okay, so remember these two words. You can review the rules. You can slightly break the rules, but you can be warned for that. But you cannot break the laws. So let us move deep inside this, something like what is this motive waves and what are these rules. So in the article, I have just shared some basic rules. So what are these rules? Wave 2 never corrects 100% of the wave 1. Wave 3 and never the shortest one amongst the wave 1, 3 and 5. Okay. And the wave 4 never intervene into the territory of the wave 1. So let us see how these waves looks like. So let me show you something. Market always moves in the patterns that recur again and again with time. Okay. I am drawing some a particular structure of the wave 1, like this is the wave 1. This is the area where some investors or where the big players have just find out the value of any of the stock, any of the script underlying. They have found out the value of this underlying. Okay. And they have just bought this stock or particular script and that bring to up to this level. So we call this as a wave 1. Okay. But how will you say this is the wave 1? Not now. You have to see where another wave, wave 2. If the wave 2 is still up to here. Okay. Now look at this wave 2. Wave 2 is still here. If I say this wave started from 61.4, okay, and gone to the level of 64.98, and from that there was a sharp correction in this stock or a particular script up to the level of 61.889. So it is still not corrected the 100% of the wave 1. Wave 1 was this, and it is still not corrected the 100% of the wave 1. So if it is not corrected 100% of the wave 1, we can say this as a wave 1. Now we can say this is a wave 1. And if this start turning from this, we can say, yes, this was a wave 2. This was a wave 2. Until and unless you does not find this, that rule number 1 holds, you cannot say this was the wave 1 and this was the wave 2. Okay. What happened if you are saying this is the wave 1 and you have just designated this as a wave 1. The underlying is coming down and you have just bought up here. Okay. And this is going to be downward from your cost and from this starting level. So will you be able to say this as a wave 2? No, the rule breaks. So until and unless you does not find this pattern, at least this, you cannot say this is the wave 1 and this is the wave 2. Okay, so let us go ahead. If this is a wave 1 and this is the wave 2, now the third wave is started from here and the third wave will be the longest of the wave 1 and the wave 2. So the third wave will be like here and it will cross the level of wave 1. So it will be the longest of the wave 1 and wave 2. Why it will be the longest, I will tell you. And after that, there will be a correction that will never go below the level of the wave 1. This was the territory of the wave 1 and this correction should not go, or the fourth wave should not go below this level. Okay. So if this level is saved by this underlying, so we will only designate if this level will be saved. So if this level is saved and the underlying is just started moving upwards like this. So we will say, yes, this was a wave 4. This was a wave 4 because it has never gone below wave 1 level. Now the wave 5 will take place around third wave, or it can also surpass this level. So how Elliott has just decided this, the wave 3 will be the longest and wave 4 should not go below this wave 1 level. So let us know more about this. What happened here? Look at this. There was a stock company listed on this market. Okay. And nobody knows what will happen with this stock. And some of the fundamental viewers and some of the big players who know the fundamentals of these stocks, they have just invested their money and they brought up the stock up to here. Some of the few investors and short-term investor who just want some money in the short term. So they started booking the profit here. on the level of this, and the stock price has declined to this level. But the company promoters and that big investors were here to save this zone, because their money was here, invested for the long time. Their money was invested at this point. And why would the company promoters and the big investor, why would they let the stock be down from their cost level? So they will save this stock to go down much below this for this particular level. And they will save this, okay? And they will form this wave two. And after that, if this stock started coming up from this bottom, now most of the traders will wait to break this high. This is the general understanding. We call it as a pullback. Look at this. Okay. We call it as a pullback in the trading terms. But what Elliott says, that this was the wave one and this was the wave two. As soon as this level breaks, everyone will identify this stock and start investing in this particular stock. Now, why would this the longest? Because everyone has identified this pullback and they will start investing their money at here when the breakout will happen. Okay. And those who have invested here, they will put more money here. Okay. They will add some money here. They will not add here or something here. They just seen the market behavior. And yes, in this rally, in this breakout, everyone will start investing their money at this level. Okay. And all the retail investors and everyone will know about this underlying. And because of this, this rally will sharply goes up more than this wave one and wave two. Because in this region, only few investors watch this. In this region, those few investors which invested here, they have just gone out of this stock. But again, if the fundamentals again strong and if they find something better, they restarted investing in this. Okay. And at this point of the level, everyone will rush into this stock. And this is the psychology of traders or crowd or the socials. Like if we see a breakout, we will only buy this if we see the breakout or only if we see some prices downward. Okay. So therefore, the retail investors, which are safe traders, they just wait for this level to come. And therefore, this wave three is the longest of the wave one and the wave two. Now, what happens? These small traders will start profit booking from the level of wave three. So when they start profit booking, the stock price will come down. Okay. Let's say this coming from here, stock price will come down. And what will happen here is coming down, and those who have just missed this rally here, suppose I was just watching this stock, okay, and I was just waiting for this stock to make a breakout and didn't pay much attention to this stock in the coming days, and the breakout happens, and when I saw this stock, I found this stock here. Now I say I missed the rally, I missed the big profits, and now the stock is coming down. Now here I will be in confusion mode whether I to invest or not. So I will also wait for stock price to come down. Okay. So the stock price is coming down, and where will I invest? I'm just very curious to just invest in this particular stock. Okay. So I am just very in a confusion mode how I will make money in this particular stock. So I will not buy here. I will just wait this stock to come down, at least something in this region, so that I can reinvest, or I can reach in this rally again. I can participate in the rally, the next rally in this stock. So as I have just missed here, many of the traders who waiting here, not because of this reason, I have not paid much attention here. There could be many reasons. There could be fear. There could be fear because of the news, because of the fundamentals of the company here. And you can also see this is there are certain patterns in the market. The pattern is like, first pattern is this, and the first top is this, and the second top is going to form. And we, some of the traders assume that this will make a double top and will fall. The double top pattern works like this. Look at this. This is the top one. Okay. This is the top one, and this is the top two. And if the neckline goes, yes, we can see a target of this length. So most of the traders also having fear at this point. So they miss the rally because this was the starting of the third wave. But yes, one who believes in the Elliott wave would have invested here, putting a stop loss just below the level of the wave two. All right. You would not be in any fear because you have just bought this stock here. You have bought a very low based on the Elliott waves patterns. So this is something you can escape out of this fear if you use this Elliott waves and if you have identified the correct wave patterns. So what happened here? If you have to invest, many of the traders will see some good support. And what will be the support? The previous support or the previous resistance, which this stock has just broken. Okay. In the just basic general trading, we say the immediate resistance becomes the support if it has broken in the previous history. Okay. So this was a resistance for this stock because in the previous, the stock turned out from this point and reached here. So if the stock is going up, okay, so this will act as a resistance. It will stall here for some times because many of the bear traders have just put their orders here to short this script. And because of this, this will halt here. Bulls will try to push to break this level, to break this resistance on the upside. And the bears will start giving their pressure downside to move this stock down. Okay, this will be the fighting area of the bulls and the bears. Okay, and as soon as this resistance has been broken, all will come and use their money inside this stock for the long-term investment or for something like a short-term target. Everyone will say this is a good support to buy. Therefore, Elliott said, this is the point we can say the wave 4 has been completed. And yes, the wave 5 can be started from this zone. Okay, if it goes below this, means this level was a good support and it also has been broken. And this stock or underlying or script is started trading below this support. So why we will buy this stock? Why we will be on the bull side? Because this was a very good support, but it has been broken. So we will not say, yes, it has having any potential still left to go up more. But as soon as this support is intact, okay, as soon as this level is saved by the bulls, we can be in this stock again for the upside. So we will say this as a wave 4. This is the wave 4. And those participants which missed the rally here, 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 or here, who are waiting, or the fresh pairs will start infusing their money here. And the stock will go upside. Up to which level? Up to which level? At least the level of the wave 3. At least the level of the wave 3. Suppose the wave 3 was here. Okay. Suppose the wave 3 was here and the stock came down from here. So this wave 5 will go up to the level of this 3. I am saying this is the minimum target, but in most of the cases we have seen this will cross. This is the extended wave and it will go above and up and up. Okay. And after completing this wave 5, we will see another correction. We will see another correction. Let us suppose that the wave 5 completed here. Okay. Now the Elliott wave identified that in the trendy market, if the trend is uptrend, okay, so the waves or the bull waves will go in a manner of a five-wave structure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And if there is a correction will take place, it will form in the three-wave structure. That is wave 1, wave 2, wave 3. Okay, so this is a correction for this stock. Okay. So we will not say this as a wave 1, wave 2, or wave 3. We will say it as a wave A because it is a corrective. This is the wave B and this is the wave C. So this five wave structure is with the trend. The trend is upside. The trend is upside. Okay. But this three wave structure will against the trend. Okay. So therefore, I have just started with this here. I just started with this scrap first 1, 1. Now I have just combined this like 1 and 2. So this is a wave 2, means wave 1 and wave 2. This was the bear and this was the bull phase. So if I combine this, I got this. If I have having a primary trend on the upside, so I will take this first. Okay, this was the first and this was the second. So first and second. Now, if I combine more waves, this is the bear 1, 2, 3. And if I have seen five wave structure of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, So let us combine this. What happened? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 1, 2, 3 on the downside. Now let us take this bear phase. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave structure. And against the trend, 1, 2, 3. And with the trend, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is, what is this? This is a bear wave. And let us see this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 with the trend, bull trend. So let us combine this. First, take this wave. 1, 2, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th. Okay. Now, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, again with a 5-way structure up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5-way structure up. Okay. So this makes something like a wave 1, or you can say this wave 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Wave 1 completed here. Okay. Or you can combine this as a wave 1 and this as a wave 2. But yes, if you see wave 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, first wave, and you will designate this as a wave 2. Now, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. And this will be 1, 2, 3. And again, you can say like the third wave is on the extension. Third wave is continuing. It's still not completed. Because if you see 5-wave structure, that is a continuation pattern. And if you see the 3-wave structure, that will be a something like a corrective phase. Okay, soon we are just switching to the stocks also. I am not just going to tell you about this Elliott Wave on this drawings, and I know you will be very curious about to see how these things was on the stocks also. I'm just giving a small introduction of this, how we can identify these waves. Okay, I have just started this all with the motive waves. Okay. Okay, what is the motive of the motive waves? The motive of the motive waves is to make the progress. And if we find this motive waves, and with this following this certain rules, we will say, yes, the trend is in the continuation and the trend is just progressing. Okay, so there are two types of the motive waves. So the first is the impulse wave, and another one is a trigonal triangle. You can say this, we can see this diagonal. We will see this, how this looks like triangle. Okay, so what is impulse wave? What is impulse wave? Now, the impulse wave is a 5-wave structure. Okay, a 5-wave pattern. If I say impulse wave, there are two terms. First is impulse wave and another is impulsive wave. Okay, so if I say impulse wave, I'm talking about that 5-wave pattern that subdivide into 5, 3, 5, 3, 5. Okay, let me show you. So, if I talk about the impulse wave, so it is a 5-wave pattern. 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is the 5. This 5. Now, against the trend, I have to go against the trend, 3-wave structure. 1, 2, 3. Okay. Now, with the trend, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now, against the trend, 1, 2, 3. Now with the trend, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. Now let us see what happens. So I call it this as a wave 1, consisting of the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 wave structure. And I call this as a wave 2, consisting of 3 wave structure, 1, 2, 3. Now again, I have seen the 5 wave structure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I will call this as a wave 3. Okay, now again, I have seen the 3-wave structure against the trend, 1, 2, 3. I will call this as a wave 4. Okay, and again, I have seen the 5-wave structure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I will say this is a 5-wave structure. So this is a impulse wave. This completes your impulse wave count. This is how you have to count. But there are certain rules. What is the rule number 1? The rule number 1 suggests the wave 2 can never be 100% corrected of the wave 1. So wave 1 was this, and the wave 2 never corrected the wave 1. Never corrected 100% of the wave 1. So wave 2 was corrected here. What was the 100% of the wave 1? The 100% of the wave 1 was this level. And the where the wave 2 completed? Wave 2 completed here. Okay? It never corrected 100% of the wave 1. Now, wave 3 started. So wave 3 was this. So wave 3 must be longer than the wave 1 and the wave 2. So this was the wave 1 and the wave 2. This was the third wave and is longer than wave 1 and wave 2. Okay. We call it as a wave 3. But if it is a shorter, yet the wave 3 has to be completed. Because if you see 5-wave structure, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, in a minute or subdivision or something lower time frame, you should not designate it as something like wave 3, because the wave 3 may be possible. Wave 3 is going to complete over here or here or here. And how will identify that? You have to see the patterns in that degree. If you see this, look at this. The wave 1 is this much long. So how can you tell this wave 3 should, if though it has given a breakout over here, you cannot say that wave 3 completed here, because wave 3 is very small, and wave 3, according to the Elliott wave 3 should be the longest of the wave 1 and wave 2. At least let us assume here, why would have been the wave 3 will completed here, because this long time investors have invested money here, and also some of the investors have invested money here. Why would they book their profit only here? This is the psychology. This is the main psychology of the trading, and why investing the money in the for the long term purposes. Okay, so this is the impulse wave. Now the another thing is what impulsive wave. This is the 5-wave pattern, and it will be as like as something with the trend. Okay, and you can say this on higher degree. You can say this is the wave 1 on the higher degree. On a higher degree means on a weekly chart or monthly chart. Okay. So let us say this is going to happen in daily charts. And if you analyze on the weekly chart, it reached up to the level of this, and this completes the wave 1. Because think like investor do not see these daily charts. They have invested money for 5 years, 10 years and 15 years. Okay. And they don't see the daily charts. They have just infused the money, and they have just left it to see how the market will react with this stock. And they come only something like in the years. They will review their invested money in the 2 years, 4 years, 6 years, 8 year patterns. They don't come daily. Okay. So these are the two terms: impulse wave 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3 against 5, 3, 5, 5, 3, 5, 3, 5. This is the impulse wave. And the impulsive wave is something like this. And on the higher degree, impulsive wave, which is with the trend. Okay. So if you have just noted that this was the great support, the rule says the wave 4 never be corrected or never go below this territory of the wave 1. Okay. Now, so this is the bookish thing. Okay. I am telling you all these rules on the basis of the book. Okay. And the practicals is very different from the bookish knowledge. You all know that. So it has been seen and it has been noted that sometimes the stocks go below this level. Okay. But never gave closing below this, never traded below this level. So if sometimes this stocks go below this level, you have to just wait for the closing on that time frame on which you are analyzing this. So you have to just wait for the closing of that particular candle. And therefore, I have told you in the beginning of the session, there are certain rules and there is one law. I have just introduced the rules. What is the rules? The wave 2 can never be corrected 100% of the wave 1. And the wave 3 must be longer than the wave 1 and the wave 2. And the wave 4 can never go into the territory of the wave 1. So these are the 3 basic rules. So the third wave should be longer than the 1, 2, and this. I will introduce the wave 5 also. This is a very naughty thing here. What happens here near the wave 3? What happens with this in the commodity market, and what happened in the cash markets? Okay. So this rule is applicable for the cash market, that the wave number 4 should not go below this territory. In the future market, it can go. Okay. It can go, and yes, I am just telling you that based on my experience, I am telling that I will show you what happens when it go below this level. Okay, and it came above this. The price is never traded below this level. But yes, we can take the chance here also. Yes, we have to take the chance. Just put your buy order here. If you have seen the third wave correcting downwards and coming here, just put your buy order here. Just take the chance. You have to take the chance. And therefore, you will be able to just grab the opportunity on the very right place. You have to take the chance. You put the buy order here and just make your stop loss, I must say, according to your risk capacity or technically for the next support, the next immediate support. Now, so let us draw. So I am drawing this wave right from this 90s, okay, 1999. So I am taking this 1999 as a reference point. Okay, so I will give this point as a zero level. Okay, this is my datum level. So I will give this as a zero mark. Okay, so this is my zero level. This is my datum. Now I will draw a line from here. First, you have to just see a significant high from the zero level and significant lows. You will be able to identify the waves. So this is the wave one. This is the wave one. Are you able to see this trend line? This is the wave one. Okay. Now, at this point of the level, many of the nobody have just imagined the prices of the crude oil will shoot up something like we will see this as a black gold. Right. So here, most of the investor invested. Okay. Most of the investor would have been invested here. And this was the wave one. So I will designate this as a wave one. Okay, but can I designate this as a wave one now? No, I have to see. I have to see what is going for the corrective move. So this was a phase one. So after this, I have seen this. This was the correction of this script. So if this is this came here, this was something support, it took like support, and if it breaks the support, if it came here, I will designate this as a wave one. I will designate this as a wave one. So this was a wave one for me. Okay, this was wave one for me. And what happened? This was my datum. This was my datum, zero level reference. Okay, so if it is a wave 2, it will never correct the 100% of the wave 1, and the 100% will be here, 10.7. Okay, so what I will do, I will try to catch this move. I will try to catch this. I will try to invest my money in this region, near to this region. Okay, so whatever could be the region, you can use different tools. Like if you use Fibonacci retracement, just put this Fibonacci level from the top, okay, here, and just connect the bottom. Look at the 50%. Take your trade at the 50% retracement. You can take the buy position here also. Again, add on this 0.618%. Add here also. Whatever, according to your risk capacity. If you want to wait for 0.618%, just wait for 0.618%. Took here. If you want something 0.786, this 0.786, 78.6%, you have to wait for this level. So just according to your risk capacity, because your stop loss is this. Your stop loss is the starting of the wave one, your reference level. If you just identify something, so you know your risk capacity, or you know the according to this analysis, your stop loss should be like this or slightly below this. So, or you will try to enter in this trade near to this level. Okay. So now it could be possible. It will correct up to here and it will go from here. It could be here also. So you have to just use some different tools for the retracement tool or something which you use for this. How could it be? How could it have gone down to enter for the trade? Okay. So here, this came up to the level of this and returned from this level. So I will designate this as a wave two. So this was a wave two. Now you have designated this wave two. Now as per Elliott wave, what is the rule number two? Yeah, wave three cannot be shorter than wave one and the wave two. Okay, so 1, 2, and 5 or 1, 3, 5, the wave three should be the longest. Okay, now at least if you have designated wave two, now the wave three should be the bigger than at least 1 and 2. So if you have invested here, so you could have a target of at least greater than wave one. Okay, wave two is itself shorter then the wave one. This is not a 100% retracement. So wave three would be greater than wave one. Okay. So let us draw the wave three. So wave three started from here and it went up to here. I am drawing this on the monthly charts. I am telling you about the super cycle, grand super cycle, whatever you call it. I will give you a better insight from the top level. Okay, so this was the wave three. And in which patterns it happened. Look, 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Are you able to see this? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5-wave structure on the upside. So this was the wave 3. Okay. Now, let us see what is happening. When the crude price was near $10, okay, the way some investors have imagine this as a story. Okay. So when the crude oil was trading at near the $10, it reached up to the level of the 36. Okay. And some of the premature or something, like we can say that the small traders just went out from the trade. Okay. And again, here, those who have invested here, they have all again added here again. And it reached up to the, and it stalled here because it was a resistance. As I said, it was a resistance. It returned from this this level. So as this was acting as a, something as a resistance. So therefore, here price has stalled and slightly come down from here. And from that, again, it reached to this. And again, it has stalled a red candle here. And you can see this again. We can see a bullish candle. Okay, this is a bullish candle. And what is the name of the bullish candle? If you know something about candlestick pattern, this is the Maru Bozu. No low has been created on this month. And just all was buying. Okay, everyone was buying here. Okay, so this was a Maru Bozu candle. And yes, this was the point where everyone participated in this rally. And everyone would have just invested here. And took the crude prices to the level of the 78 point, or we can roughly say 78.5 levels. So this was the wave 3. Okay. So I will designate this as a wave 3. Okay. And from this level, crude prices, this script is going to be for a profit booking. Okay. A corrective phase. So up to which level it will, suppose you miss this here, you miss this opportunity here. Okay. So, and you wanted to trade in, you wanted to take this trade on this crude oil. So where will you will invest? You will wait for, where will this correction will be completed? So you will wait for the wave 4. Yes, wave 4 should not intervene the territory of the wave 1. Okay, so let us see. Does the wave 4 went into the territory of the wave 1? Let us see. This was the wave 3 completed because we have a significant high from this low. We have a significant high here. Okay. And from this, there we have seen a profit booking and we reached to the lows of this $50 range. Okay. Now you have the opportunity of from this level. You have opportunity to invest from this level up to this 50%. You can say if I will introduce a Fibonacci retracement here and I must be worrying about only for 50% retracement. I will be not greedy to take the trade for 6 months. Look for the 61.8% or 78.6%. So from this low, I will be more concerned about the 50%. Look at this. This is very near to the 50%. Okay, so I will draw a region. I will not fix a point that I will buy here only. No, what could have happened that if your price will not come to your buying zone? Okay, so let us draw a region, at least 50% retracement from this level. So this was the 50% retracement. This is the zone of your buying zone. Okay, so this was the buying zone. This is the support zone. Okay. This is the support zone. And we will see what is happening in this zone. I will tell you what is happening in this zone because this is a very good support. And currently we are just hovering here only. Lots of bears having a stop loss hunting and lots of bulls having a stop loss hunting in this region. This is a very, very, very irritating region for the crude oil. Just because of this, just see this. You will be able to identify what is happening with you in the intraday also. Okay, so this was the region where you could have gone long. Okay, so I will designate this as a wave 4 and it never intervened the territory of the wave number 1. So this was the wave 4 and it has been observed that the wave 5 is a extended wave. in commodities, in every commodities. Okay, so I have just told you that at least it will go to the level of the wave three, means the prices would have been again the $78.5. Okay, but yes, it broke this level. It has broken this level and it went up to this level. So I will tell this as a wave. Okay, it came to this level. So I will say, yes, the wave five is started. The wave five is started from here. And it when it has broken this high, again, most of the big investors have just identified the value of the crude oil in that year. Okay, what was that year? That was year July 2007. Okay, this was a strong pullback. Okay, and this was the last opportunity to go long in the crude oil for the long-term purpose. Okay, just because of this wave one, wave two, and wave three. This wave three already has been happened. So this was the last time, last chance for going long on the crude oil for the long-term purpose. Okay, so what happened here? Look at this. After that, you can see the size of the candles on the monthly chart. This is the monthly chart. Just see what is happening after the breakout of this level. Look at this, the size of this candle, again a consolidation, again the size of this candle, bull face, consolidation, profit booking. Look at this. And where the crude oil prices reached $148. Okay, near the $148 means I will roughly say $148 because it is it had made a high of 147 point something and it reached to the 147. Okay, so this, and from that level, it has just having a sell-off. Okay, now this was if you have been having some knowledge about the candlestick pattern, this was a bearish engulfing pattern on the monthly charts. Okay, so this was an indication of the profit booking. Okay, and if you have been following, or if you could have the knowledge of this Elliott wave, you could be very careful about this. Is the end of the wave five. This is the end of the wave five, and the long correction could have been taken place at that time. And just see what happened after that level. Okay, now just imagine if watching these big monthly candles, someone has just invested money here. Someone has invested money here for having a long-term purpose investment on the crude oil. What has happened with his money? Look at this. This is a complete sell-off on the monthly charts. First month, second month, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, seventh. Continuous 7 month selling. Okay. Why? Because this completed the five-wave structure of the bull phase. The first, second, third, fourth, fifth. And after that, we have to see a wave A. It cannot go like a rocket. Okay, so we have to see a wave A, and yes, this was a wave A, corrective wave, and three wave. We have to see the three wave on the downside, because this was a five wave structure on the upside. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now I want to see three wave structure on the downside. 1, 2, and 3. So look at this. This was the A wave. This was the A wave completed here. This A wave completed here. Now the V wave. But why he? The V wave will be complete here. Okay. So this is the V wave. Let me draw a trend line. Means indicating line. This is the wave A. This is the wave B, okay? And yes, now this is the interesting part of this analysis. How long this wave C will go? So currently, this is the wave C. Now let us draw a wave C. I want to see this wave C in this zone, okay? This is the wave C. And we are currently in a long-term corrective phase on the crude oil. Long-term corrective wave. Some analysts assume that the correction has over. That the correction has over, and the correction itself took here. And this is the something like starting of a new phase. This low was the starting of the new phase. And some analyst is seeing this as a bull phase. Okay. This as a bull phase. But the point here is we are on a higher degree. And if we have seen a higher bull phase, higher degree bull phase, so we have to see the same degrees corrective waves. Okay. So still I am not considering this, that the correction have been over, the C wave corrected here. We are in the C wave. And the C wave itself is going in the 5-wave structure. Do you want to see the 5-wave structure? Let us see what was happening here. So as I told you, the market works or market trade in a pattern. So after this sell-off, this correction, there was something against this B wave, okay, with the trend, okay. And there was a formation of a symmetrical triangle. Look at this. This was a symmetrical triangle pattern. All the big players were watching this. And suppose someone having someone not having a knowledge of these patterns, not having the knowledge of this Elliott wave, they have just thought that this was a correction. And yes, we will see this again going upside. So what happened here if somebody have just invested amount here or here? Nothing. They had just invested against the trend. Look at this. So this was a symmetrical triangle pattern. Okay. So A point, B point, C point, D point. And look at this. This is because this was a bear. If we see from here, so this is a bear trend. Okay. And for the bear trend, look at this. Okay. Yeah. Now this, as soon as this symmetrical triangles have given a breakout on the downside, look at this. What happened? This was the level of the 105. And look this. The prices came here. Okay. Again, short covering in this month, April month. Okay. And we reached here. Again, a sell-off. Look at this. Here. Okay. So, I have just told you that we are in a C wave. Okay. We are in a C wave. And C wave will complete at least here. Okay. $26 around. And it can also go even below if we follow the technical analysis and if we follow the Elliott wave analysis 100%. Okay. I'm not surprised to see the crude oil below the prices of the $25 also. Okay. But again, a very strong disclaimer, this $25 will not come tomorrow, day after tomorrow, next month. No. Okay. Don't try to catch this. Don't try to short and on any arbitrary level. Okay. This all analysis is just for watching, just for observing, just for your knowledge, not for trading. I'm not recommending any trading. Okay. Now, I have just told you that this C wave is taking place in the 5-wave structure. So, what is that 5-wave structure? Let us see. Look at this wave 1. This triangle, this whole triangle is a wave 2. Okay. So, the wave 2 completed here. Okay. And now the wave 3. Wave 2 and this wave 3. Look at this wave 3. Okay. 1, 2, 3. Some of you will tell this looks like something bigger than the wave 3, wave 2. No, this is not a bigger. Okay. It can be bigger. Yes, it can be bigger. But yes, it should be in a form of triangular pattern. As soon as, because these are some guidelines also. Listen, everybody, we cannot learn this whole Elliott wave in just 2 hours. Okay. So there are much more things to know about this. But yes, on a basic thing for swing trading, you can apply this. And if you know this, the direction for the swing trading, you can also apply for the intraday. You will be more confident in intraday also. I will show you how to see this for intraday basis and how to see this on the lower time frame also. So this was the wave 3, okay, and wave 4. Now, let me clear all this and I'm afraid doing this trade in this crude oil. This is an international commodity. And based on this analysis, don't take any trade on this crude oil. Okay. At least not on the crude oil. So this was the wave 1, wave 2, and the wave 3. So as I said, this rule is holds for something in the bull phase. It will also hold for the in the bear phase. So we are in the currently in the bear phase, and wave C, and we are A, B, C. Currently we are in the higher degree. We are in the wave C, and this wave C also happening in the impulsive wave. What is the impulsive wave? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so this one has happened, two in the form of the triangle. And let us draw a region for wave one. Okay, so this was the region. So this is the low and this is the closing price. Okay, this is the closing price. Now, this is the wave three. Wave four should not intervene the territory or cross the wave one. Yes, okay. So let us see what happened. Look at this. Wave 3 completed here. Prices went up. Look at this. It started moving up, going up. And look at this beautiful thing about this Elliott wave. Look at this. Can you imagine this? What happened here? Look at this. Can you see this? This is the wave 4. This is the wave 4 of this 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 structure. 1, 2, 3, 4. And the fifth wave is going to start or already has been started. Okay. If this is a wave 4, now I want to see the wave 5. Now, where will be the wave 5 will complete? The wave 5 will complete at least the level of this low 3. Okay. At least. Means $26 or $25. Okay. This wave 5 can also go beyond the level of the wave 3. It can also cross this $25. It can also go this way. Okay. I will be not amazed to see the level of the 25 level if this whole analysis is correct. I am again saying if this whole analysis is correct. Okay. And what is the invalidation zone for this? What is the invalidation zone? The invalidation zone will be this. If the crude prices will cross this level of this $76, this will be the invalidation of this whole analysis. This whole analysis will be invalidated when the crude oil price will cross this $75. And if the $75 or $76 crossed and the price is sustained here, this will be the trend change. Okay. Trend change. Okay. So this is the wave 1, wave 2, wave 3, wave 4, and the wave I want to see the wave 5, at least the level of this. And this will not come in this coming few months or something like this can take place in the year something. If it has to be completed, it has to be completed in the year something 2021, 2022, between this range. Okay, this time zone. Yeah. And yes, we have been trading crude oil daily basis. And if something Sharat say, yes, I give advantage to his analysis because his fully market structure base, he don't see much indicators. And I am something like I see indicators. We having approach difference. But yes, we are having in the same overall, our decision is same. Okay. And once our views are different, the market will not move. The market remain range bound. It yes, that is the thinking of the big traders. If two opposite thinking are different, so big players are also thinking like that. And the crew, any prices will will be just in the range bound. Okay, so let us continue again. So this this fifth wave can be in a. This is the monthly charts. Okay, this cannot be this level of 25 will not come in the next this year 25 or something this. Okay, December, January, February, what is this is the monthly charts, and you just see what happened. Look at this. This is the year of 2009, and we reached up to the level of this 107 in the 2014, and right from 2014, just look at this. In the 2 years we have just reached to the level of this. Now, will you say this is in the bull phase? I will not say this is in the bull phase. Now, imagine this, the level 2016, from 2016 to this 2018, it took 2 years to reach from $30 or roughly, $30 to this $75. Okay. We took this this time to reach up to this level, and just look at what happened. First sell-off second sell-off and the third sell-off. We again reached to the $42 zone in the previous year. Okay. And again, we have seen, now look at this on the shorter time frame, this on for clear insight. From the month of the January, this was a bull phase. Second, third, fourth continuously buying months. Okay. And look at this. What happened here? It took just only 1 month to cover this all three candles. Look at this. Okay. So I am bearish. Yes, I will say I am bearish. Okay. So unless any rules violate, any something indicator or anything, if I am not satisfied with something bull indication, I will be bearish on the crude oil on every higher prices until the level of this. Okay. So now let us see something already drawn structure of the, look at this. I have just drawn this for you. Okay. So let us go into the lower time frame. I will again use this crude oil. Okay. So let us see for this crude oil in the 4 hour chart. So I will convert this in the 4 hour chart. So when the crude oil was trading on the level of this zone, 66.5 zone, we were traveling from here. Okay. From $42. We were traveling from this December. Okay. We reached here. And I've been trading, yes, I have given the long-term targets because this was a head and shoulder pattern. There was also a head and shoulder pattern. Yes, there you can get information about this pattern. We will not be going to discuss this head and shoulder pattern. So I gave the target for this also. Okay, it happened. And look at this. It reached up to the high of this 66.6 zone. And from this level, we have seen a sell-off. Okay, this was a sell-off. So this was the indication of something like what happened here when the crude prices was going. OPEC saying, yes, we will take the crude to the $80. And yes, day by day or every weekly inventory was just negative and supporting the buyers. So what happened here? There was a technical resistance here on your daily time frame. Just see the previous history of the on the daily charts. Okay, from this level, we have seen a sell-off here. Okay, and this was in the form of three-wave structure. Look at this three-wave structure, 1, 2, and 3. Okay, and as soon as it reached to the, it hovered here, it reached to the level of this. Okay, so now I am going to explain this with the trading psychology. Okay, what could have happened? Nobody has thought that we will just short the crude oil here at the level of 66 zone. Okay, nobody have just thought, but big players have their in their mind that we will short at this level. So they have shorted and the crude prices reached to the $60 level. Downside rally, straight downside rally of $6. Okay. But when somebody was telling this, yes, this somebody will take this as something like a correction. Okay. Forming this trend line and any of the trend line, like from this $42 also, you can draw a trend line. So general view was this, like this can be a trend line. This could be a trend line if this broken. So look at this. So many of this, but if you are following the Elliott wave analysis, look at this. Big players just retrace to this level, okay, and as soon as this wave one just cross breakout happened, everyone has just participated in this rally and they have shorted this crude oil here, and they have just shorted and they have seen the straight rally to the level of the $50. Look at this $50, and we have just caught this move. We have just caught this move from this level, okay. From $60 to this $50, we had just caught this rally just because of this wave one and wave two. That wave three should be the longer than the wave one and the wave two. Look at this. We reached to the level of this. And look at this. How the wave three, because this was a correction of that rally. Okay, so look at this. Wave one, wave two, and wave three. We reached to the wave three. Okay, and now from here, we have just went a steep rally or a steep small correction of this downside up to the level of this. And again, we have just reached to the level of this. So this was forming as a A, B, and C. Look at this C, how the C is long. Look at this C, A, B, and C. C zone is went up to this. Okay, so when crude oil was trading here on the level of the 57 and the 56 zone, I have just posted a video idea that crude oil will reach to the at least to this zone, $60. And when the crude oil reached to this zone, we have seen a correction. And when the crude oil was here, there was an OPEC meeting. And the OPEC meeting, in the OPEC meeting, they again said, we want to see the crude prices above the $80. But yes, soon after the OPEC meeting, we have seen this correction. And after that, we have just went up to this level, made a high of 60, near 60 point this zone. Okay. But yes, this was a C rally and this was a fourth wave. So as the rule number four suggests, fourth wave should not enter in the territory of the wave one. So the territory of the wave one was this. Okay. This was the low. Okay. So this was the low. I will draw a channel. This was the low. This is a, and the closing was this. Okay. Look at this. So this is happening in the 4 hour chart. And if I convert this in the daily charts, look at this, what is happening in the daily charts. Look at this, no significant candle, no significant bullish candle in this region, in this resistance region. Look at this. I'm using the word region. Okay. So we have never went up to this level and traded above this zone. If we have traded, we have been, we could have just say that this is the invalidation, but it never happened. Now what happened? We have seen a sell-off from here, and when the crude oil was here, I was very confident just because of the Elliott Wave Analysis, and I posted an idea like that it will go here and again we will see a sell-off from here and we will see at least a target of this $50 again. Means you could be able to grab this $10 move of crude oil when it was trading near 60-61 zone. Just because of this short-term trading, just because of this short-term Elliott Wave Analysis, I have, look at this, I have just taken this reference. I have taken this reference zero level. Okay, so this was the reference level for me as a wave one. The wave one was here. It started from here, the wave one, and wave two never corrected 100% over here. And the wave three reached up to here, the wave four here. And I was just very sure it has to complete the 5-wave structure, it has to come again up to this level. So it has again came to this level. Okay. And now see how it came here. Look at this ABC. This was the A, this was the B. And look at this. See, hold this wave four structure gone. Wave one, wave two, wave three, wave four, wave five. 5-wave structure. And now look at this. The wave, this five in the 3-wave structure. Wave one, wave two, wave three. Okay. Now from here, what is happening in the crude oil? Look at this. If I take it as a correction of this downside movement, or if I say this rally, this move is completed. Okay. So if this move has been completed, so we will see a correction of this move. So what will be the correction? It will take in a 3-wave up, 3-wave down, whatever the pattern could be. Look at this. We have seen a sharp rally up to this level. Okay. So this was the wave A. And from that level, we have seen a downside movement. So we have taken this as a wave B. So I was taking this as a wave B, but no, this should be taken as a wave B because just look at the degree or the degree of this wave. So the degree of this wave also should be something like this. Okay. So this is the A, this is the B. I'm not saying that, yes, it is a wave A, it is a wave B. If it is a wave A, if it is a wave B, so wave C should be completed here. Okay. So it could be like a 1, 2, 3 patterns and or 1, 2, 3. This is the wave A, B, or something like 1, 2, 3 patterns and 1, 2, 3 patterns. So C will be corrected over here. So again, this will be invalidated in the region of if the crude prices will go and close below the level of the 52 zone. Okay. So this correction will be invalidation. So these are the hypothesis. Okay. So these are the hypotheses I have just created. If it could be, it could have just given a breakout in the previous session, it could have just reached to the level of this to make a double top here, or it can make a double top here. Okay. So again, if you have been seeing this crude oil every week, you have been noticing that every rally is not sustaining on the upside, and the bears are shorting this, and the bears are shorting this on the shorter time frame. It has to break the level of the $50. Okay. But when it can be happen, we cannot predict. Time can be predicted? No, we cannot predict. But yes, we can have a rough idea with some different analysis. Okay, there are different analysis. We can we will come with that analysis also in the with the medium of this Trading Sutra platform. So this is something like you can apply this on the shorter time frame. I have applied this on the 4 hour chart. If you see this on the 1 hour chart, just go with the three wave pattern, just go with this triangle, just go with the triangular structure and all. Okay, this was also drawn. Look at this pattern. This is also a pattern. Look at this. When the crude prices were trading here, I have just drawn this level as like this, and it will go here. So it had reached up to here. Now either it will reach to the here, or it will go to this zone, choppy zone. Okay. So if it has to come, it has to come here. So it will hit the level of the 52.63 according to this pattern also. Okay. So I'm not giving you any tips. Okay. I'm just telling you the different views. What could happen with this crude prices? Okay. Now, so I'm done with the crude oil. I'm done with the Elliott wave analysis. Now see the chart of the Avenue Supermart. Look at this very beautiful chart. Okay. And what I have just told you, it is happening as per that analysis. And you will see, I am telling you, you will see that this will happen according to this also. Okay, now look. This is the listing price of the Avenue Supermarts, and its IPO came around the level of 400 or something like, and it has just gap up opening and it listed here. Okay. And yes, I have this stock in my holding since IPO. So this went up to here. And from this level, we have seen a significant top. And from this level, we have seen a downside movement here. So this was the wave one. If I have taken this wave two, so look at this. It went up to here, but it never crossed this level. And also wave one was this, wave two was this. So rule number one holds very beautifully. The wave two never corrected 100% of the wave one. Where is the 100%? This is the 100%. Okay. So wave two is here. If I have taken the wave two here, but I am seeing this, look at this. This is forming in bull mode. Yes. Ascending triangle. Yes. This is the ascending triangle pattern is being formed here. Okay. And now look at this. What will happen? If you want to buy this stock for intraday for anything or something swing trading, just buy it. It will go here. It has to complete this pattern. It will go here. Just buy it and have a stop loss here. Or according to your risk capacity, it will hit this level. Surely it will hit this level. Okay. And from this level, if it faces some resistance, just short it. Short it and just look for the target on this trend line. And yes, as soon as it got support here and it start moving from here. I repeat, if it starts moving from here, just buy it. Have a stop loss below this point and just hold it. Look at this, what will happen? A, B, C, D, E, third touch and on the bull face, and look what will happen with this pattern. Can you imagine? And this will be the end of the wave two. And now imagine the wave three. This should be the wave three should be greater than wave one. Now look at this. So this is something like which you never miss. Okay. You have to take chance. These all are bookish. You have to take chance. Now, if I say about this fundamental, check the fundamentals, go to the DMart, go to the malls of the DMart, go to different cities and see. Every new DMart mall is opening in the metros and every new cities. Okay, you can see the expansion of this business. You can see the financial results of this company. This is a company of an investor, Mr. Ramesh Damani. Therefore, this company is named as the DMart. Okay, so I am finishing this stock.
All right, guys, I'm back again, and that's it for today's video. I hope you enjoyed this tutorial video with Manish and learned something new today. Do like this video, and if you have any query, ask in the comment section and make sure that you subscribe to this channel. And I will see you in the next one. Take care. Bye-bye.